Hello， 大家好，欢迎来到北欧林彬彬的频道。
Perfect， 好
，Awesome。
我们刚刚吃了一顿非常美味的火锅，当然是跟我们的公公婆婆还有小叔子了，把他们确实震惊了一番。
是的 ，Having such a huge, delicious 火锅 meal really reminded us of our time together in China. Coincidentally, that is what today's video is all about.
因为屏幕前有很多小可爱一直在问我们的爱情故事，我们发了第一部是怎么认识的，如果你还没看的话记得到这边去看一下哦。而且今天是我们结婚3周年的纪念日，
是的，
所以我们想借此机会再跟大家分享一下我们的爱情故事。今天是说我们在中国一起生活的这段经历。这段故事的开始是从 Evan 搬到中国开始，那个时候其实我们才刚在一起还不到半年，那你就直接搬到中国去找我，你当时是怎么想的？是不是脑子有一点太冲动了？
蹦蹦的。I think the way we met each other was quite special, but it forced us to make some serious decisions about our relationship quite early on. Watch this video. But I think if you decide to give something a try, you might as well give it your best try, or not try at all. So we gave it our best try.
但是你当时不会担心会出错吗？
Scared.Yeah, it's always scary to make big decisions like that, but I just felt like we're such a good couple. I had to see it. were you scared?
其实我刚开始是既兴奋又矛盾，因为我之前从来没有跟任何男生同居的经历，而且他又是一个外国人，而且我确实也遇到过渣男，当时其实是处于一个不太相信爱情的这种状态。那我的家人也不是特别赞成，因为我们俩毕竟刚在一起没有多长时间，所以我家人知道他要搬过来跟我同居之后就已经炸开了锅。但是和他在一起之后呢，我每天都觉得特别开心，然后我们两个人就有聊不完的话。我们那个时候在他搬来之前就是每天都要视频的时候，我们最长的记录是一天可以不间断视频8小时，就有说不完的话，就超开心。我觉得我在他面前可以做自己，就是状态比较放松，这种状态感觉特别好，以前从来没有过，也不用担心说我每天跟他说话他就会觉得就是我很黏人，就以后就不喜欢我了什么的。我觉得我们两个聊得越多，反而他对我的感情就越深，所以我才有勇气大胆的跟他一起尝试做这个同居的决定。
Yeah, I think especially this whole topic of family matter is really quite extensive. So if you want us to make a separate video just about that, let us know in the comments below. Very briefly though, I'll say your family is great. They're really understanding, really sweet, really nice. But I think at the beginning,I really wanted to show them that I was a great, you know, good, reliable guy, but it was kind of difficult. I was like coming from the other end of the world. I didn't speak Chinese. My Chinese was very basic at that point, even though it's still pretty basic, but it's a lot better than it was back then. And I came that I didn't have a job. I was living off of my savings. It didn't give a great first impression. But luckily in Denmark, education is free.And actually the government gives you some money to study. So that along with my student job meant that I had savings that I could use during our time in China together. Even though I used almost all of them.
是的，那时你这么远跑来中国，然后又没有工作。所以当时在中国的话，支出是我付的比较多。后面搬到丹麦之后的话，基本上都是你在经济上支出了。所以那时候我们在中国没有过像其他的外国人那样非常高档奢侈的生活，但是我们在我们的能够承受的范围之内，我们过得还是小日子，很滋润的。我们还去了周边的不少城市去带他体验中餐啊，去看旁边的风景。我记得有一次我们去无锡那边，然后我无意间去了一家凉皮店，那一次买到凉皮，哇，真的，我现在都有点流口水，
哇，
超级好吃，这是我们吃到最好吃的一次凉皮。对
，My God, I remember that trip to 无锡. That was such a good trip.
灵隐寺大佛那边，而且我们当时还在那个求子佛那里给他投了点硬币，投币去求子。然后我记得当时我还在那里求一个双胞胎，虽然这个没有愿望没有实现，但是我们要宝宝的这个计划还是挺成功挺顺利的，所以估计这个投币给这个大佛还是有点用的，谢谢大佛。
谢谢大佛。 Speaking of Buddha, I remember it was in Wuxi. I had that funny little like Buddha shaped apple thing.
什么 apple?
It was like this what, apple. It's some fruit, little Buddha apple. I have a picture.
Here,
this one. This one. It's this one. That looks so ugly.
Yeah.
这根本就不是苹果，这是小人参果。小人，这是什么？这是人参果。不认识。我知道，这好吃。后面还去了苏州、杭州和昆山、常州等。不过我们去苏州那一次的话，我对它发了很大的火。我那次真的太恼火了，但是呢。
发完火那次吃的那个中餐厅也超级无敌好吃，虽然我们在外面等了一个多小时，但是真的超级好吃。
喂，
呀，我对你发火，你不记得了？
你为什么对我发火？
那是因为我太生气了。
为什么？我忘了，我真的忘了。
事情的缘由是这样的。当时他是一个外国人，对不对？然后在国内的话，我们出去玩的那些城市，所有的行程、所有的细节都是我安排的，包括订机票啊、订酒店呀、订到哪里吃饭呀、订景点呀，然后具体的到每个景点，我还得要跟他解释一下是什么东西，然后。一天下来真的很累，而且我们那天在苏州那边还有那种当地的小团，人家就会拉着你去。我想他是一个外国人，又怕人家到时候会宰我们，所以呢，我要问清楚一点，人家具体要干嘛的，对不对？这个外国人他在旁边就说，哎，在那叽叽喳喳叽叽喳喳，他又着急又很想问说，哎，要问清楚，不要让他们带我们去那种只是买东西的地方，不要让他们就额外赚着我们钱。那我已经很着急了，在那种情况下，我已经很生气了，而且还有一个外国人在旁边叽叽喳喳叽叽喳喳一直在问，哎呀，我就把这些心中的怒火压下去，压下去，哎，压下去。然后到晚上，我们到去吃晚饭的时候，到金鸡湖那边，那个时候已经真的是非常非常累了。然后到餐厅又排队，因为那个餐厅实在太火了，等了一个多小时，终于要坐下来要点菜吃饭了。然后这个人呢，拿着菜单，每一个菜都问我，这是什么东西做的，这是怎么做的，每一个都要问一遍。那一本这么厚的菜单，你说我当时都已经又累又饿又发火，你知道吗？我实在是不想给他解释，我就想赶紧把这些菜都点完，赶紧就上菜吃了饭回去睡觉。我真的不想给他解释，我就很生气，当时我就说，你怎么这么烦呀，不要问了，我就不想跟你说话了。
Really?
是。
That happened? Why don't I remember this?
反正我当时就很生气，我就我不想说话了，你自己不会看吗？对，然后他就很无辜的眼神看着我，就说：“啊，你为什么要这样对我说话呀？我一什么事情都没做过呀。”
Yes. Why are you so mean?
哎，但是我真的很生气，是不是？哎，你说如果换作是你，屏幕前的小可爱，假如说是你的话，你会不会很生气
？That's 不 okay.
那我真的很气很累，怎么办
？What?Why don't I mean, it can't have been that bad. I don't even remember. I guess it made a big impact on you since you seemingly remember it so vividly.
Yes.
But
I was so angry.
Yeah, I get that. But you know what?
Yeah.
You know what I do remember about that trip? Yeah. That bus trip was totally a scam bus. We drove around all afternoon looking at stupid souvenirs. Until we got off the bus because we didn't want to do it anymore because it wasn't any good. 气我 My questions were very valid, okay? And you just got mad at me.
这个话题现在讨论到这里的话，其实就深入到下面一个话题，就是跨国恋之间由于文化和语言障碍而产生的一些矛盾。这个真的是你没有办法避免的。但是如果你能站在对方的角度替对方考虑，因为其实对于他来说，当时他确实是想帮忙，但是他又帮不上，又干着急，所以他又想参与其中，他就给我一些建议，也没有做错事情，对不对？那对于我来说，忙了一天呢，我从查东西啊，什么细节都得要，我不光身体累，我还口干舌燥，我心灵上也累。本来是想出去度假，我怎么觉得这么累呢？对不对？所以 我已经完全 totally exhausted 了。那我当时在那种情况下，当然不想再继续跟他一一有耐心的说下去了，所以我也没有错。后面我们又深入讨论了这个话题，他理解我当时的心思，为什么这么生气，我也理解他其实是想帮忙而又帮不上的这种感觉。所以其实作为跨国情侣的话，在由于文化和语言上面的差异而产生的冲突，这个是不可避免。不过如果两个人都能心平气和的摊开来讲，又能互相谅解的哈，这个方面的矛盾还是可以被解决的。
I agree. Really, especially when you enter into a relationship with someone from a different culture or a different language where you don't really understand what's going on, it really is important to try to see things from the other person's perspective so you don't end up getting frustrated or annoyed. Communication really is key in that aspect.
异国恋确实需要彼此付出很多，而且需要更了解更理解彼此。比如说异国这个就是一个非常非常大的挑战，因为你需要签证才能到另外一个人的国家去，而中国和丹麦又是两个非常难能够拿到签证的地方。他丹麦到中国来每次最多只能待三个月，那三个月之后的话签证到了他又需要回来，这样的话每次往返买机票最便宜要4000左右吧，签证要1000块，这样又把我们两个人在一起的成本又提高了。花费都是小事，最主要的是你没有安全感，因为你两个人不知道哪一天你们两个人可能就又得要相距9000公里之外了。那在这种情况下的话，如果你不是两个人特别特别相爱，也不是特别信任对方的话，或者就没有特别坚定要在一起的话，真的很容易就分开了。那还好我们两个人当时对彼此的感情还是比较坚定，然后确信要在一起的。而且还有一点就是他当时在中国没有工作没有收入，那又要这样子一直花费，其实对于他来说经济上的压力是挺大的。那如果他要是在丹麦不来中国找我的话，其实他在丹麦找工作，因为他是丹麦名牌大学毕业的嘛，其实是很容易就找到一份工作了。而且即使他在这边没有工作，他有这边的补助，他一个月还可以有15000的收入，就可以轻轻松松的找工作，就可以拿2年。所以对于丹麦人来说，他们刚毕业的话，其实大家都不着急找工作，都很悠哉悠哉的在找，会精挑细选找自己喜欢的，然后再去做。而我父母这边呢，觉得我找了一个快年纪30岁的外国人，竟然连一份像样的工作又没有，这就是30岁，所以其实他们不太满意了。但是还好，我们两个就一直很坚信要在一起。我们的感情也非常好，我们那个时候其实是苦中作乐了，然后在外面就是我们就压马路呀逛公园呀，然后我下班的时候他每天都会去接我，然后周末我们经常就是背一半西瓜然后就去公园坐在那里，就在那里其实也不说什么，就边吃瓜然后边在那里享受一下两个人在一起陪伴的时光，也挺开心的。
It really was a very nice time in our relationship, and our relationship really developed a lot during that time.But it was also a stressful time for all the reasons that you just mentioned. I met a Danish guy at a networking event. And he said that he could get me a job. Oh, he would like to hire me in his company. He could get me a working visa, blah, 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 blah. And everything was fine. I kept asking, you know, working visa, how is it going? What can I do? Blah, blah, blah. And he was like, yeah, everything is fine. It's going well, blah, blah. It's still the plan, blah.And months went by and it seemed like nothing was happening, to be honest. And Bimi has a lot of experience with visa application stuff. She was like, I don't think anything is happening.
对的，我觉得就是通过几次他们给的反馈，我发现其实他们根本就没有做什么。因为我非常懂，如果你真的到了这一步，你拿到反馈是什么。所以在这种情况下的话，我们就有了进一步的决定。
Yeah, so it was beginning to get really stressful. My visa was running out again, which meant we had to do another visa run back and forth, spend a lot of money on that, and my savings were almost out. And if I couldn't get this job, couldn't get a working visa, it's like, what are we even really supposed to do? And that's when I got a phone call from my best friend who told me that he had just been diagnosed with cancer. And that, like, changed my mindset completely immediately. So instead of being like, oh, I'm so worried, how can I stay in China?How can we make this work immediately? It changed into, I actually want to go back to Denmark for a while. So we sat down and we talked and we both agreed our relationship is the most important thing. That's not what this is about. But maybe it makes sense for me to go back for a while to take care of this first.
这样我就尝试着搬过来。
是的。 Yeah, living off of savings with no income really wasn't a good feeling. But at the same time, we were both enjoying our life together in China. So it was a difficult situation. We ended up deciding that I should go back to Denmark so that I could be close to my friend. And from there, I'd look for a job in China that could help me get a working visa. However, it wasn't very long after I came back to Denmark that media was full of stories of how it was going to be more difficult and more expensive to get permanent residence for Denmark.
但是这个签证的问题真的是太繁琐了，它花了我们将近一年的时间，而且由于这个签证的问题，我们两个又做了一个非常重大的决定。这个决定的话，让我们两家人都全部 shock 到了，都已经完全震惊了。因为今天视频到这里差不多了，如果大家想知道我们做了一个什么样的决定，想看这个视频的话，记得留言告诉我们哦。我们两个人是怎么样在这么一个剧情跌宕起伏的情况下，最终走到一起的？这个真的是有很多可以跟大家分享的。好，那我们今天的这个视频就先到这里啦，希望大家看得还开心，祝大家情人节快乐，也祝所有的在异地当中，或者是正在进入一段关系，但是有很多困难的情侣们能够顺利的克服你们所有的困难，最终走到一起。如果你还喜欢这个视频的话，记得关注我们啊，
给我们302。
行，那先这样，谢谢大家，下期再见，拜拜，
拜拜。